Hi, good morning, my friends. So today I just got back from, well, actually, we got back early this morning, which was kind of like last night. It was like 1 a.m. We got back from our trip to Colorado. There's pictures and videos online on Facebook. Just search my name, Stephen Schwen. We were called by the Lord to visit Colorado and spread the ashes of my deceased father-in-law, Brian Griffin. So it was definitely a calling from God because it superseded the plans we had already made. And there was no way we could escape it or get away from it or get around it. You know what I'm saying? But he used us mightily. And not only did we complete our task, but we served his good. And we're led into many opportunities to uplift and serve and help our fellow man as well. So it was all good. Today, I feel like the Lord is directing me to simply read to you a chapter of Proverbs. So let's get into some wisdom. I'm not going to share my feelings on the verse at all. I'm just going to read straight from the Word and let the Lord talk to you through His Word. Amen. And I like chapter 13 because it's got a three in it. And if you know that the Lord moves through the number three, can I get an amen? The number three is blessed. If you see a number three in your life, the Lord is showing you some favor. Okay, look for it. It's a sign. Amen. He loves the number three. So chapter 13 of Proverbs, a wise son heareth his father's instruction, but a scorner heareth not rebuke. A man shall eat good by the fruit of his mouth, but the soul of the transgressors shall eat violence. He that keepeth his mouth keepeth his life, but he that openeth wide his lips shall have destruction. The soul of the sluggard desireth, and hath nothing, but the soul of the diligent shall be made fat. The righteous man hateth lying, but a wicked man is loathsome, and cometh to shame. Righteousness keepeth him that is upright in the way, but wickedness overthroweth the sinner. There is that maketh himself rich, yet hath nothing, and there is that maketh himself poor, yet hath great riches. The ransom of a man's life are his riches, but the poor heareth not rebuke. The light of the righteous rejoiceth, but the lamp of the wicked shall be put out. Only by pride cometh contention, but with the veil advised is wisdom. Wealth gotten by vanity shall be diminished, but he that gathereth by labor shall increase. Hope deferred maketh the heart sick, but when the desire cometh, it is a tree of life. Whosoever despiseth the word shall be destroyed, but he that feareth the commandment shall be rewarded. The law of the wise is the fountain of life, to depart from the snares of death. Good understanding giveth favor, but the way of transgressors is hard. Every prudent man dealeth with his knowledge, but a fool layeth open his folly. A wicked messenger falleth into mischief, but a faithful ambassador is health. Poverty and shame shall be to him that refuseth instruction, but he that regardeth reproof shall be honored. The desire accomplished is sweet to the soul, but it is abomination to fools to depart from evil. He that walketh with wise men shall be wise, but a companion of fools shall be destroyed. Evil pursueth sinners, but to the righteous good shall be repaid. A good man leaveth an inheritance to his children's children, and the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just. Amen. Much food is in the tillage of the poor, but there is that is destroyed for want of judgment. He that spareth his rod hateth his son, but he that loveth him chasteneth him betimes. The righteous eateth to the satisfying of his soul, but the belly of the wicked shall want. And that's it for chapter 13. Amen. I got a good word from that, and I hope you did too. Be blessed and mighty in the Lord today. Be confident and secure in His love, and that His hand of favor will rest on you always. I love you all. I'm rooting for you. God is, Jesus is, the Holy Spirit is. We're all rooting for you. Just keep your head up. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Amen.